Ewen Mathieson, married to Diane, four children. We farm here about 10 k's west of Riverton, just on the boundary of Colic Bay really, looking out over Favo Strait towards Stewart Island, so pretty special place. Pasture renewal is very important to our business. We're endeavouring to improve performance all the time. Pasture renewal is an important part of that, incorporated into our cropping regime, I suppose you might say. So poorer performing pastures going into crop and then being replaced with better performing pastures and behind that. So I suppose going forward, there's actually, you know, one of the things we're actually starting to think about now is what that pasture renewal actually looks like. We're actually looking at how we can minimise the pasture damage and what composition of pasture might help us in that space. When we're actually thinking about our system as a whole and the challenges that we face around global warming, potentially longer dry periods in the summer or more extreme dry periods in the summer, then how can we actually build more resilience into our pasture system in that space? So it starts with paddock selection about 18 months or so out from actually crop placement. And that selection process is around environmental concerns and risks and also around animal welfare stuff, is to minimise environmental impacts but create the best environment we can for our animals around shelter and underfoot conditions. We've worked through that process. Once paddocks are identified, then we'll actually look at soil testing to identify what nutrient requirements are there or required. There's no point wasting nutrient. One of the key constraints for us here is often soil conditions, which means that we don't always wind up with as many growing days available to the crop. Understanding that our yields will reflect that. Therefore, there's no massive push to throw a whole lot of nutrients to try and achieve something we're not going to achieve because we simply haven't got the growing days. So part of our approach around identifying at-risk areas, DairyNZ has some very good tools in that space around critical source areas, buffer zones, strategic grazing. Some of the key actions that can be taken around identifying at-risk areas is involvement in discussion groups so that you actually get mentoring in that space from other farmers. Also, catchment groups are playing pretty key roles in that space as well, engaging farmers and understanding what their areas of risk are and how they can mitigate those risks. Yeah.